Our next question comes to us from Catherine.
Yep.
She asks, there are so many different levels of fear, anxiety, agitation, up to full-blown terror.
Mm-hmm.
I find myself in one of these emotions frequently.
Mm-hmm.
I feel I'm connecting to some of the emotions causing the fear, but my fear is being ramped up. Is this normal, or am I not feeling the cause?
Mm. Well, g'day, Catherine. Good to see you again. Yes, this is something that we need to be conscious of, is that usually when we begin emotionally processing any causally based emotion, so childhood emotion,
mm-hmm.
we go through a whole series of stages or steps. Now, I've written about them many years ago, and probably what we'll do at some point is probably have a Q&A about those steps.
I'd really
because
like
we,
to.
Because we realise it's something that a lot of people have never read, and therefore probably don't really understand. But let's go through some general parts of the steps. Firstly, you go through an intellectual awareness, or you start with no intellectual awareness and no soul-based awareness.
Yeah.
Usually that's where you start. In other words, you're in complete denial, both intellectually and emotionally. And then, of course, the first step generally is we become intellectually more aware. So in other words, we go, well, you know, I must have some emotion because my mum and dad treated me this way, and my school people treated me this way, and the teachers treated me that way, and, you know, through my life this. So I must have some emotion that I have to feel, but I just can't feel it. So this is what I would classify as an intellectual awareness developing, but still not much emotional or no emotional awareness. Then as we go down, and I won't illustrate in this discussion all the different steps down into mm-hmm. complete to a soul-based awareness, but as we go through the intellectual awareness stages, and there's four or five of those, we get to the point where we start becoming emotionally aware.
Yeah.
And this is what's happened to Catherine with regard to her fear. So before it was just all a sort of theoretical discussion. Now she's starting to feel some of her fear. So she's gone from being completely emotionally unaware of her fear, in other words, suppressing this fear, dramatically suppressing it inside of her soul, resisting it completely, which is all about the principles of resistance and suppression
mm-hmm.
in how the human soul functions. And of course, while she's been resisting and suppressing those things, she has not been very sensitive to other feelings either, because once you shut down one emotion, you also shut down others. So she's been in this state for a lot of her life,
yeah.
shutting down whole groups of emotions. Now that she started to allow herself to get into a state of emotional awareness, she's starting to feel some of these feelings that she's processing. Now, there's seven or eight steps of emotional awareness too. Some of them we go through instantly and other ones take many months to achieve, mm-hmm. depending on the levels of emotional resistance that we have to the experience of an emotion. And this is why I say we probably need to have a discussion about that subject
yes.
at some point. But for Catherine, she started to go down into these areas of soul-based processing through some of the emotion. Now, when you get into this phase of your processing of emotion, the real emotion, the hurt child's emotion in this case, because all of our fears generally are related to the hurt child's emotion,
mm-hmm.
what happens is that you start. There is an intensifying of the emotional experience. That's because you're now in allowance. Your allowance of your emotion is improving, and therefore the emotional experience, which you have been up till now suppressing, is now improving. So in other words, you're now becoming more sensitive to the emotions that are inside of you. And of course, if the emotion is fear, then that means that you'll become more sensitive to the feeling of intensifying fear.
Mm-hmm.
You'll start feeling it bodily, you'll shake a lot. Stuff before that you weren't even doing at all, you now are exhibiting through your body, you're releasing this, if you're truly releasing, you're releasing this causally based emotion. Now, during that phase, it does sometimes feel like it's intensifying.
Mm-hmm.
The reality, though, is this level of fear has always been in you, but you've just not allowed yourself to experience it, and you've used techniques, mm-hmm. sometimes a lot of techniques, in order to suppress it. And some of these techniques include physical techniques,
mm-hmm.
such as using, your movement and your way you get, you know, moving out of the way of emotion, busying yourself, working hard. I know working hard's been a very big thing for Catherine. Mm-hmm. So she's been used physical ways of avoiding the emotion. She's also used emotional ways of avoiding the emotion. In other words, substituting emotion for other emotion, mm-hmm. blaming herself when mm-hmm. she shouldn't be blaming herself and things like that. She's used emotional techniques. She's sometimes resorted to substances like food, mm-hmm. for example, to avoid the emotion. And most people have a long list of ways that they've used to suppress and deny emotion. And then as they've deconstructed that, which I know Catherine has done over the last few years, you start becoming more sensitive to what's really there. And for a lot of people, it is a shock what's actually there, the depth of the intensity of the emotion that's present. But the emotion isn't actually intensifying in the sense that emotion has always been there inside of you. It's just that now you're allowing the experience of it. And remember, emotion, like energy, becomes emotion once you experience it. So this emotion is now being allowed to be experienced,
yeah.
and of course it has a feeling of intensifying.
Yeah.
And this is a phase that everyone will need to go through with regard to every type of emotion.
Yeah.
Not just with fear.
Sometimes it feels to me like a tensed muscle.
Yes.
And it goes numb.
And you don't even...
You're holding. You don't.
Yes.
You lose awareness, really, of that. And
you
then
can't even feel it.
Yeah.
Even. You get to a point where you can't even feel the physical pain of it, even though your body is obviously in physical pain, because once you start to release it.
Well, that's what I was going to say. As I seem to soften up more, my yeah. soul, suddenly there's more pain everywhere.
Everywhere.
And it's like there's a muscle that's been tense that I've been holding on with my resistance to keep these emotions
yes.
shut down and not moving.
Yes.
And as soon as I soften and they begin to move, the pain seems to intensify
yes.
massively. And
yes.
it was always there. It was just that my will has changed. Where
correct.
I was once holding it down, now it's moving, and that gives me more sensitivity to it.
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course. And this is what people need to get used to. You see, what happens generally, though, is people are not used to this. What they do is they start allowing the sensitivity to their emotion. Then they start finding the emotion gets fairly powerful
mm-hmm.
because for the first time they've actually allowed its true experience.
Yeah.
Because it was powerful as a child, like extremely powerful as a child, but you were often powerfully suppressed as well. And, of course, we've learnt and purposefully learnt, many of us, techniques to suppress so that we don't have to bear that kind of pain. And so what we do is because we've learned all of these techniques, we've powerfully suppressed these powerful emotions. So once you take away all of the suppression and take away all of the resistance, the emotion starts to flow and as a result, it starts to flow and it feels like it's intensifying. And it's a phase that we need to go through until we're at the stage where we're truly feeling the real experience, which will be very intense,
yep.
actually. Very intense experiences are what cause us to heal. We allow the experience of the locked up intense experience, then we will have some healing effect from processing the emotion. And this is a process that we go through. It's the opposite process to how the emotion was suppressed.
Mm-hmm.
If you think about it, we initially had the emotion, then the heavy suppression instantly, and all sorts of techniques and everything piled a whole heap of stuff on top of this emotion. And what we've done is start to pull it all apart, wash it all down, if you like,
yeah.
until we get down to the real problem. And the problem is going to be a very smelly problem because it's been festering in our soul for years and years and years,
yeah.
and it's going to be quite intense to go through it.
Yeah.
And you need to learn how to process through intense emotions. You need to learn how to do that safely, and you need to learn how to do that, you know, relying on God, and you need to learn how to do it for your own sake.
Mm-hmm.
And so that you don't have to rely on anybody else to do it. You need to learn how to do it without damaging yourself. You need to learn how to do it without damaging other people.
Mm.
And this is all a part of your learning process, actually, mm-hmm. in terms of how you become your true emotional self.
Is it a part of understanding our soul, really?
Yeah,
and
it
the
is.
Will of our soul and yeah. the nature of our soul.
And also that we don't have to fear emotion.
Yes.
You see, most people have tremendous amounts of fear of emotion itself, and fear is what causes most of our pain.
Yeah.
If you're not afraid of your emotion, it's very rare that a lot of pain will occur. You'll have emotional pain, of course, but you won't have as much, anywhere near as much or any physical pain once you're feeling your true causally based emotions, the hurt child emotions. Mm. So you know, I feel she's going through a natural process, which she's begun.
Yeah.
And I know Catherine, and I know that she's also now accepting more truth. She's finding more truth about her personal life is coming to her. Mm-hmm. She's found more and more out about the role her father and her mother played in her abuse. And as a result, you know, there's going to be a lot of fear to feel, unfortunately. And the key is to rely on God and trust the soul's process.
Mm.
Just let that, trust that soul, the soul of yours that God created, trust that God created it to cope with anything, and allow yourself to go through the experience. Your fear of the experience is going to cause pain. So what happens for Catherine is every time she gets afraid of the deepening emotional experience, she often then tries to run away from the emotional experience, and that's what causes some physical pain and also causes some spirits to overcloak her in that moment and affect parts of her organs of her body and so forth. And that could all be avoided as long as she just allowed the process for it.
Okay, because I'd like to ask you about something else I've observed. So in this case, we know Catherine. We know she has a fairly sincere will to look at herself.
Yes.
And to deal with her fear.
Yeah.
But I have observed in other people, especially when it comes to the emotional release of fear, begin to touch into their fear.
Yep.
Their soul-based desire is not to experience fear,
correct,
not to experience the truth about fear.
Yep.
And so they then attract a lot of spirits who are in a fearful state.
Mm-hmm.
The person doesn't want to be there themselves. They absent themselves, and a lot of spirits get involved in, it can feel like a ramping up of fear for that person.
Yeah, but it's not really, is it? It's a projection from these spirits towards them of their own fear.
Yes.
And the reality is when we try to avoid our own fear, we will receive these projections. And in fact, there are many, many spirits in the spirit world who have a complete desire for every person on earth to deny every fear, and they have a complete desire to help you deny every fear as well. And that's a whole different discussion about spirit influence, really, and how it occurs.
Okay.
Yeah.
So in that case, we wouldn't see any relief.
No. There'd be no relief. There'd be no growing truth.
Yes.
There would be no growing awareness of the situation, of what the cause is. There'd be no connection to the childhood experience, the fear-based childhood experience. Catherine's had many fear-based childhood experiences that have been suppressed. And that she's now allowing herself to open up to and remember and experiencing. And this is a good indication that she's actually doing some true emotional work.
Yeah.
Whereas a person who's just getting overcloaked by spirits isn't doing those kind of things generally. They're really, because they don't want to face their own fear, they're now experiencing the fear of other people. And of course, if you don't want to feel your own fear, you will attract many people around you, both on earth and in the spirit world, who tell you, don't do it, it's dangerous.
Yeah.
You know, there are so many therapists have been told, you know, just be very, very careful how you, you know, work through issues with a person on with regard to helping them, because it can be very dangerous. And it can be very dangerous, but only when a person is in desire to avoid.
Yeah.
And of course, most people who go to therapists have usually a feeling that they want the therapist to solve their problem, and they also generally have a feeling, as most therapists know, that they wish to avoid their own emotional experience. And this is what causes the danger.
Mm-hmm.
If you truly absorb and allow your own emotional experience, you will never be in any danger.
Yeah. Great. Thank you.
Yep.